Now let's look at the object repository functions, right? For example, there is a plus sign over here. Okay, this plus sign is same as add objects to repository, which was there in the object spy. Okay, when we used to spy the object, right, this you have this add object to repository. The same operation is over here as well, right? If you open UFT and make sure that the application is behind UFT, you click on this, UFT will disappear. And whichever object you click on, that object will be added inside the repository. Okay, now two things. There are many other functions over here which we'll be talking about. And secondly, suppose if I click on this and if I click on say weather. So the hierarchy is that there is a browser, there is a page and there is a link. Okay, now if I want to add all the objects of the page inside the repository. Okay, I can click on page. Instead of selecting link over here, I select page. Okay, and I click on the OK icon. So what will happen is that I get this window. You either select all object types or default object types. When you click on OK, so you will see that it will actually add all the objects from the web page inside the repository. But generally we don't do this. We don't add all the objects from all the pages inside the repository. We don't make the repository so huge. More than 70% of the objects from a page you might not also use. Okay, but since the feature is there, I'm telling you, right? Okay, similarly, if you don't want to add all the objects, you want to add some links on the page, right? You click on the page and click on OK, and you can now, there is an option to filter the objects. Select the object types which you want to go for. Okay, and you can check the object types which you want to go for. For example, from this page, I want to extract, say, all the buttons. So I'll uncheck all the other ones. Hold on. Okay, and only keep the buttons checked, right? Or if I click on okay, so it will analyze, and there are two web buttons on this page which it has added in the repository. Okay, now if I want to find out where is this web button, okay, there is an option known as highlight in application, same as object spy which was there. Okay, I can click on this and that button would be highlighted. It is probably somewhere at the bottom. Hold on, web button. Yeah, over here. You see that? This is the search button. It's getting highlighted. You see that? Okay, so this is how you can work with object repository. You can add all objects. You can add objects of your choice. Okay, it is completely up to you. Then you can highlight it as well. Right, now another thing is update the object, right? For example, if I add, hold on, if I add the object, say, just a minute, let me delete everything, hold on, let me delete the code as well, right? Okay, now say if I add, hold on, just a minute, my mouse has hanged. Yeah, so if I add this object, say I add the news object, right? I drag the news object over here, and now suppose I want to update this object. Tomorrow the news object is not there and you want to replace sports with news. Okay, right. Now if you click on this icon, update from application, you select the object over here in the repository which you want to update, and then you click on the link on the icon, update from application, and click on sport. Okay, click on OK, the object would be replaced. Okay, the object would be replaced. You will actually not see the wording news changing over here, but the actual object which will be found in the application will be changed over here. Hope you got the point. You will not change, you will not see the external name changing. This is just a eyewash, right? The internal name, it is actually changed. If you can also change the external name yourself. You can write over here sports and hit the enter button. It will change in the application. So you can update an object. You can update an object from the application. Okay. Right, that is very easy to do. Okay, now I'm sorry. Now if you click on add objects to local, hold on just a minute. Right, if I try to update the sports object again, right, this is the update from application icon, right, if I click it again and if I click on the shop link over here, this is the shop link, right, if I click on, then shop will be replaced. But if I suppose click on this text field search, right, and click on OK, you will get an error. Look, to replace an object with another object, the classes should be same. You cannot replace a link with a web edit. You cannot replace a link with a web edit. That is for sure. Okay, this is the link. You cannot replace this link with a web edit. Alright, so you have to make sure that the objects are of the same class when you are replacing them in the object repository. Okay, right, so few functions, right, from OR, adding objects manually, adding all objects, adding selected objects, finding OR from app, that's fine, that's okay, right. So this was about updating, right. Then next, the next sign over here is add insight object to local. Okay, we'll talk about this later on, right, hold on. Objects by, locate in repository is another important thing. Like for example, if I'm adding the objects in the repository, oops, make sure that the application is open behind the scenes. If I'm adding the objects in the repository from the complete page, okay, suppose I have added, right, and now I want to find out where is the text Monday April 13th, or where is the link, whether in the repository. Okay, the opposite of locate in application. Okay, locate in repository. In locate in application, you used to find the object where it is there in the application. Now if I want to do the other way around, that where this object whether is present in my repository, okay, then you can use this sign, locate in repository. Okay, you click on this, you click on weather, click on OK, and this will highlight weather over here. This is weather in your repository. Okay, so these two things are opposite. Highlight in application will find the object in the application, you see that it's highlighting, and locate in repository will locate the future link inside the repository. Okay, right, now moving ahead, suppose you made this repository, you worked one day, you make a repository. Now you want to share the repository with other team members so that they can use the same repository which you are using. You don't want every team member to be using a different repository. You can also do that. When you work in a team, okay, when you work in a team, you have got various team members. Now you don't want all the team members to use a different object repository. Okay, so you make a common object repository and ask team members to share that object repository in their or to use the object repository in that test. Now how do you make that? How do you do that? Okay, right, let's study that. Now for instance, you have to save this repository. You can go to file, export local objects. Okay, so you can export the complete repository. All right, hold on. Yeah, so you can export it anywhere, say in my F drive, I'll put it inside say QTP. Okay, I'll save it as repository1.tsr file. Okay, the extension would be test shared repository TSR. So when you click on create, and now if you go to your F drive QTP, you'll have this TSR file, repository1.tsr. This file you can mail to your colleagues and all, everyone, so that everyone can include in their projects. Okay, so all they'll have to do is that if I create a new project over here, hold on, you'll have a completely new repository for every project. You have a new repository. Okay, hold on, repository. So over here it's creating a new test, and if you go to tools, resources object repository, and you can associate the repository, okay, from your hard drive. You can import the repository from your hard drive out here. The icon to do this is this one, associate repositories. So you click on this icon, right, and you'll have this option to add the repository. You click on this, you'll see repository1.tsr. You select this, select action 1, drag it to the right side, click on OK, and you will have this repository coming up. Okay, right now, but you will observe that this object repository is not editable. You can drag the objects, that is fine, but once you are importing the object repository from your hard drive, it becomes uneditable. You cannot change the names over here, you cannot do anything, because it falls under the category of shared repository. When you are using shared repository, okay, you cannot edit it directly from the object repository. So there are two types of object repositories: local object repository, which directly is made when you simply work on your machine, you record, run, write. But as soon as you export it into a TSR file and you include it in the project, okay, you cannot edit the repository. Okay, to edit the repository, you have got Object Repository Manager over here. Okay, this can edit your TSR files. You can go over here, right, you can select the option file open. Okay, you can open repository1.tsr file, and you will have this icon, enable editing. Okay, you click on this and you will have all the objects coming up. You can name the object anything, right? Suppose frame is over here, I rename the frame to test. Okay, I hit the enter button, file save. So this will actually save it back into repository1.tsr file, and this repository1.tsr file is currently in my current test as well. If I open my current test, you will see that the test has automatically come up over here. Okay, the updations will come up in the test case. You edit it from the manager. I'll rename my frame 2 to test underscore 2. Okay, I'll rename it to this, save it. Okay, go to my test, and I'll see that test underscore 2 has come up. Okay, so the thing is, right, if you have a this is your object repository which is on the hard drive. Okay, if you have shared it in multiple tests, okay, the moment you change the object repository with object repository manager, okay, it will automatically update inside the tests as well. Okay, so this is a good thing. You are editing the repository, and automatically the objects are getting updated inside the test cases as well, right? So there are a lot of things. Now inside this you have got a lot of tools like object repository comparison tool, object repository merge tool, right? So we'll be talking about these as well. If you have got two TSR files, you want to merge them. Suppose you get the TSR files from your team members, right? How do you do that? We'll talk about everything now.